Breaking news tonight, Diddy, party, cocktail, cocaine, and horse trank. That's horse tranquilizer. Did he actually feed this to his guest?
You should know that several of the individuals, and when I say several, I mean many, who did in fact seek medical treatment were drug tested, and drugs were found in their system, weird drugs. Drugs that you probably never heard of. One in particular that continues to pop up is a drug called xylazine, or trank, which based on our research is known as a horse tranquilizer.
Horse tranquilizer. If it knocks out a horse, what does it do to a lady? Say average weight 105 to 125. What does that do to a human being?
The typical MO at one of these parties that have been widely discussed in the press was that when you are handed a drink, and now we know that the drink is laced with something, if you refuse to drink it, you were kicked out of the party. Now, let that sink in for a minute. I mean, the admission to this party was that you had to drink the chosen drink that was handed to you. And now we know that in most cases, I would say 90% of the cases, these individuals were drugged with some sort of drug. That was kind of the MO.
How many victims potentially do you think there could be?
Thousands.
Those who were never at these freak-off parties, what were they like?
The ritualistic behaviors, the drugging, putting girls in the suitcases, dumping them in alleyways. It's horrifying. It's been happening in front of everyone's faces for decades. For decades.
In today's shocking update, the FBI has uncovered startling details. Debts about the infamous Diddy cocktail served at exclusive parties. Investigations have revealed that this cocktail was not just a hit among celebrities for its unique taste, but also because it was secretly spiked with horse tranquilizer. The presence of such a potent substance raises alarming questions about the safety measures overlooked at these high-profile gatherings. And what was truly on the menu, as we dive deeper into the scandal, it becomes clear that this was no ordinary mix-up at the bar. This revelation about the Diddy cocktail not only shakes the trust many had in these glamorous events, but also exposes a darker side of celebrity party culture that many might not have been aware.
But you know what happened? You should have never sued the liquor company. That's where you f***ed up. You f***ed. I don't give a f*** about you tearing up booty holes. You f***ed when you sued the liquor company, because the liquor company is owned by the biggest conglomerate on earth, the BlackRock people. You done bit off the hand that was feeding you, and now you done chop both your feet and your hand off, and your head's coming next. You was making money with your just shut. You just thought your ego got out of whack because you was controlling everything at them freak parties. Now you think you control the hand that's feeding you. Stupid mother. He sued the liquor company May 2023. November 2023, Cassie come up with the lawsuit. Connect the dots. Cassie got two checks. She got a check from the liquor company people that put her up to doing that. And she got a check from Puffy to try to keep her quiet.
I want to see some behind the scenes footage from a Diddy freak off party.
When he comes to a P. Diddy party, this is what happens to the white man.
It's so unfortunate.
You gotta pull back, though. They can see. That's Craig over. Back out the way. You're still alive. Look at that. Look.
What you got? A drink out his hand.
And that's James from Simeon Mobile Disco. He is an actual DJ. He's not supposed to pass out. But when they come to one of my parties, this is what happens to him.
It's the same thing. And it all involves some sort of drug. One instance, an individual who was 20 years old at the time was asked to attend, just saw her on the street, asked to attend a party in a hotel. She was flattered, went to the party, was given one drink and doesn't remember anything else. Ultimately, was so messed up, went to the hospital where they found cocaine and this horse tranquilizer in her blood system.
Whereas that, if I could say this, like, you have a girl, there's one guy, maybe going down on him, and he's back there rolling his eyes, he's hiding the mother, and when he put his head down, there's one of them white boys sucking on him.
Oh.
You understand? That has happened. You understand what I'm saying? Then you got these guys who, they go into these Turkish houses. Once you get to that door, you don't go back in there. But you know what they do in the Turkish houses. Well, you can assume what they do, quote unquote.
Okay, so Suge Knight did an interview detailing exactly what Diddy was doing with the hard-boiled eggs. It's called the hard-boiled egg test. And what this dude was doing was using it to test dudes to see if they were ready yet for his parties. Basically, these dudes would be taking a hard-boiled egg and trying to insert it. And if it broke, then you wasn't ready yet. I'd really be talking about this in the middle of an airport. And I wouldn't really believe all this wild stuff, but like, what is actually going on here? Why are they just posing with an egg? That's Russell Brand and Diddy. I can't stand it here. I hate it here with all my heart and soul. What is he doing? You never go egg to mouth, bro. Using eggs to determine if a man is wallered out enough to be able to party with Diddy is diabolical.
As the case unfolds, a flood of new evidence has emerged from the ongoing FBI investigation, implicating more high-profile figures and deepening the crisis for Diddy. The discovery of the Diddy cocktail, laced with horse tranquilizer, has sent shockwaves through the entertainment industry, revealing a level of recklessness that was previously unimaginable. With each passing day, more names are dragged into the spotlight, painting a grim picture of the parties once thought to be the pinnacle of celebrity glamour. The FBI has hinted at forthcoming charges, signaling that this scandal is far from over. This explosive situation is compounded by the damning evidence tied to the cocktail, making it increasingly difficult for Diddy to navigate the mounting legal pressures.
Another individual, 26 at the time of the occurrence, was picked up by, allegedly, by Mr. Combs and several other people in a black SUV from the airport. Was given one drink in the SUV and then literally woke up the next day not knowing what had happened, but with pain and damage to both.
Got me a Lamborghini.
That's nice.
I haven't gotten it yet, though.
Yeah. When is that coming, that Lamborghini? We talked about this last time.
He had the Lamborghini for a day or two, and he had access to the house, and he knows better than to be talking about the things that he does with Big Brother Puff on national television.
Guys, the leaked video of Justin Bieber partying with P. Diddy has just emerged, and it looks horrifying. It looks completely terrible. This right here is Justin Bieber. And what does that look like? That looks like a Justin Bieber that's just out there. He's not fully there. Something's going on, and I have the full video, which I'm gonna play for you guys. But before I play the video, this is exactly what I'm talking about. There is more that's gonna come out. The truth will come out. And from the research I've done, you can see from my face, I have seen some terrible and horrifying things.
I've been to a couple Diddy parties. Now, I'm risking a lot by saying this. I've been to lots of parties. I've been to Jamie Foxx. I've been with Snoop, T.I. Like, I've been to lots of places. What I will say is that one particular party, lots of big names, there was an artist there who said, hey, Lecrae, around 1 a.m., make sure you're not here. And I was like, what? You just don't want to be here at 1 in the morning. And I was like, now my pride kicked in, like, yo, you don't know me. Like, I, you know what I'm saying? Like, I can handle myself. Like, I'm not some little church boy who ain't never seen nothing. Like, I'm good. Like, you know what I mean? Like, what you talking about? Well, it's probably 12:30. I'm downstairs. I go downstairs to the studio. I come up out the studio and I'm headed back upstairs to like the main area where everyone's kind of congregating and hanging out. And the music changed. It was like really hard and heavy at first, and then, you know, like jam and dancing music. And it was a little softer, you know, it was a little more sensual when I came out the studio and started going upstairs. And on my way upstairs, there's like this couch. And on the couch, I saw a couple of guys really going at it, hard and heavy. And and I was like, oh, you know, my brain, I'm thinking, well, you know, this celebrity party, people do what they do. As I started moving upstairs, I passed them up and I noticed that it wasn't just those two guys. It was more and more people just going at it. I was like, okay, it's time for me to roll. I'm going to grab my stuff and I'm going to get up out of here. I did not know that's how this went down. So was that shocking? Absolutely. Was I forced or coerced into anything? I was not. But why they felt that comfortable, I don't know. Maybe the invite list, they was like, yeah, all these people, I don't know. I'm shocked.
So do you think Puffy was not shooting?
Only they can answer that question. Right. I have my own opinion, but I wouldn't slander their name like they did mine. Right. I wouldn't say things that I knew, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I do believe so. I have proof, things that I could say that would back up my claim, but this is not for the world to know about. Right. You know what I mean? It's between me and him, and only he knows. Right. So every time he say it didn't happen, that's the only thing that makes this become an issue to everybody. Cause you see what I said in the vibe article. I basically bowed out and was gonna go ahead about my life. The next issue, that wasn't even the next issue, cause them cowards waited about 4 issues before they got their story together. 4 issues later, half of New York is commenting on me getting shot. And before, they was all like, we didn't see nothing. Mm. In the first issue, read it, vibe viewers. Nobody seen shit. The 4th issue, when they came back with a reply, everybody knew what I did. They knew what I said. I was acting. Who gets shot 5 times and acts? Oh, I didn't get shot 5 times in their vision. I only got shot once because they found the bullet. The police found it, but now they the cops. Now they doing detective work. They found the bullet. Oh, you found the bullet, huh? So what is this other shit in me then? What was the doctors talking about? What? Can you explain these other holes in me? I like your gunpowder all over me. That insulted my intelligence. So yes, I did say Thug Life was dead. Yes, I bowed out, all of that. But when they said that, they breathed new life in me. Yeah. And Thug Life not only became a rap group, but it became a way of life for life for me. Okay. Because they disrespected me, my name, my family, what I had been through. They said that I couldn't be in pain. Yeah. I could not feel, I could not be hurt.
Is there still a beef going on with you and Biggie?
It was never a beef. It's only a difference in opinion.
Right.
To me, if I, like, my homeboy Sugar gave me the best advice I could ever give from anybody. He said, when people ask him if he's beefing with Bad Boy, with Puffy, he says, like, me going to a playground and picking on a little kid.
Right.
That's like me being mad at my little brother because he getting cash now. I'm not mad at that. I'm just mad at my little brother when he don't respect me.
Yeah.
Now, when you don't respect me, I'm gonna spank your ass. I don't give a fuck how rich you.
It's a dangerous thing. God protect us from our mind talking us out of our powers of manifesting anything that we want if we believe in you, even if it's not there, even if it looks like it's not gonna come. God, please bless everyone's mind and know that you will always show up and you will show up on time. God, please bless everyone that has had a rough year, but bless us for the good days, the bad days, the days that we have experienced death, the days we've experienced life, loss, happiness, victory. However you give it to us, we want to give you thanks for 2020. 2020 has been an incredible year. 2020 has been a great year. Please bless us that in 2021, we're not the same that we was in 2020, that we have excelled, that we have gone to a higher frequency, a higher level of consciousness, a higher level of kindness, a higher level of self-love to eat the right things and to take care of ourselves, a higher level of self-love, especially, I mean, for anybody, but for my people, Black people, please bless them to love themselves enough to start fighting back in any way, because nobody should be oppressed like this. Nobody should be treated like this. And God, I know that you know. And God, give us the courage in 2021, if anybody's being oppressed, to be able to destroy their oppressor. And God, 2020 was something. 2021, we pray. We pray. We pray it's better than 2020.
What's up, man? You good?
I'm good. How are you?
All right, young brother, everything's good? Selling out arenas and everything? Starting to act different, huh? You ain't been calling me and hanging out the way we used to hang out.
Well, I mean, you try to get in contact with me, you know, through all my, you know, partners and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
But you never really got my number, so.
Correct. Okay.
My number?
Kids have like an hour left. So get extra comfortable, kids, because after that, y'all gotta go. It's a wrap for y'all, because this thing turns into something that when y'all get older, y'all don't want to come to. Okay? So, you know, let's just start to get our groove on a little bit. In an hour, we put the kids away, it's all good. All right, DJ, let's hit it. Let's do it.
My opinion, one of the ones that affects me the most is Justin Bieber.
Do you have the Kevin Hart one?
Which is odd, Pat, because he gets caught saying that he would wake up next to him and then he changes it and says we would fight off over the Frosted Flakes. Even Kevin Hart is uncomfortable because you're admitting that you were sleeping next to a freaking child. And it's like, I'm tired of hearing all these stories and people just laugh about it. We giggle, like, this is it.
That's my brother right here from day one. We used to wake up and, I mean, damn, pause, but like, check this out. I mean, back in the days when he was like 10 and I was a little bit older, his older brother, we used to fight over the Frosted Flakes, you know what I'm saying? Before pause was invented, you know what I'm saying? But it's my brother for real. We used to actually wrestle off of the Frosted Flakes because he used to always get up early. And now he's one of the richest stars in the world. And
yo, what the fuck Puff just said? Nobody's going to acknowledge this but me. Puff just said we used to wrestle over the Frosted Flakes. And we're streaming live. That was stupid. Listen.
And his management was backing him off. But it wasn't until Usher took over management and had guardianship and gave temporary guardianship to the diddler for 48 hours. Think about that. He had already been to the hospital. That situation that Gene was talking about. And you still took Bieber there, but you got custody of him first. Yeah. Diddy had already tried. They wouldn't let him. Actually, someone made reference to the fact that Diddy trying to get at Bieber the way he was trying to get at Bieber was looking a little predatory. And then Usher came in and discovered it and managed him and got custody of him and promised to look after him. And then he sent him to the diddler. Does that sound like a good guy?
It's horrible, it's horrible.
Does that sound like a good guy? Now that we know what Diddy's really like. They're not seeing what the intentions was in his heart when he took Justin Bieber there.
Oh.
Let's be honest. He took Justin Bieber there.
How was Diddy able to maintain such dangerous secrecy for so long? Was there someone else in power shielding his actions from the public eye as more unsettling details surface? These questions become more pressing with Diddy's trial date. Set for May 5th, 2025, the countdown has begun, and the stakes couldn't be higher. The list of high-profile names implicated continues to grow, and the legal ramifications are expected to be monumental as the date approaches. The world watches, eagerly anticipating the full exposure of the depth and breadth of this scandal. This trial isn't just about Diddy, it's a window into the darker corners of celebrity culture that could forever alter public perception.
And he says, I want to sing for you.
It was at the studio of Jermaine Dupri's. I said, you know, why don't you set up a meeting between me and your manager? I'd love to meet with you and do this in a formal setting. I'm late for an appointment with Jermaine Dupri,
right,
and I don't want to keep him waiting. Let's just do this the right way.
And then you have him come to audition for you, right?
Actually, there were a few people. My wife at the time.
Right.
It also was Perry Reed, L.A. Reed's first wife.
You were all sitting in a room.
We were in a room.
Yeah.
And I showed her the video. And Perry says, are you crazy? You better get down there and meet this kid right now. He's amazing.
When all these dick pics come out and all this stuff with Bieber's... Are you the mastermind behind that? Say, listen, show off your big... There's some people that come to those concerts. Or are you sitting there...
Is that the kind of manager he's doing?
Usher, are you sitting down with him and saying... Yeah, or leave it in your pants? I mean, do you sit him down and say, look, part of this is PR,
hey,
man.
By the way, he does have a brain of his own.
Yeah, but were you shocked at the size of his...
Hey, listen, he has a mind of his own. What he chose to do with his... This is his prerogative. He's managing that aspect of his life.
But Usher is somebody...
I have nothing to do with Justin Bieber's private part.
It's real crazy how Puffy get booted out the alcohol business and Jimmy Iovine steps in with Andre and Snoopy promoting it.
It's never a good look when it comes to the culture of hip hop and for our community, our people. I turn myself in. Sometimes you gotta face the music. That's most of the time. Puffy, I'm gonna give you some real advice. Two quick things. You gotta make a decision. When you go to prison, either you're gonna be standing up pissing or squatting, sitting down pissing. I advise you to try to take the first one. Because you know, if you're squatting and pissing on the seat, you know what that means. Oh yeah, by the way, do not do your time going by Brother Love. Brother Love is not a good code name for prison. I'm out.
Whispers of him stepping down from a lot of things, but I didn't know about all the other people
I got a list right here. Shit. I got Simple a list right here. Within 24 hours of the Diddler's arrest,
yes.
Kevin Lyles, music exec. You know who Kevin Lyles is?
I actually met him one time, yes.
Well, he looked
like Russell Simmons, right?
Yes. Yeah, so it's like 90s, but yeah, he... Anybody know who Kevin Lyles is? He's probably put on your favorite singer, your favorite artist. He's probably had his hand in that. The Rutgers president stepped down. The GM of Martha's Vineyard stepped down.
Rutgers. The president, university?
That's what it says.
Oh, God.
The New York City councilman, a doctor, CEO, assistant coach. Like,
y'all
got to
see my face right now. What?
But what you gotta realize is going back to the producer that sued him. You remember the producer? Lil Rob.
Okay.
Going back to that, in that suit, you gotta realize that we found out from that suit that Diddy, in every room in his house, he had cameras. He had cameras in every room in his house. He recorded everything. That's what he was the one who. He sent the video of Stevie J to, just trying to get him.
Yeah.
You feel like, oh, everybody's doing it. I can get you a Grammy. You know what I mean? Mm. He was the one who was trying to entice him about the free calls.
Yeah.
But apparently Diddy has all these tapes and recordings, and he took his phone at a lot of them and just would start recording stuff. So he has hours and hours of film and footage of a lot of stuff. And apparently
he looking around like, damn, like, a lot of guys kissing each other in here, man. You feel me? What y'all do is y'all business.
So you've been to a party and seen this?
Oh, I've seen it firsthand, multiple times. Man. I've seen Dwight Howard in a pink dress, bro.
What?
I've seen Dwight Howard in a pink dress with two other trans ladies in dresses. They all the same height at a Diddy party. Oh. Ask about Dwight Howard in Mexico.
What's up with Dwight Howard in Mexico?
You know, they don't got paparazzi out there like that. You feel me? They was down there hooping. He going to the club with these same trans ladies.
What are you doing? Just having a little drink before my car picks me up. Where are you going? I'm gonna go to join Diddy. He's doing that. Rick Ross is doing a little concert this afternoon. Really? Honestly, they get bigger. No, I just lifted this bra up. It's like night and day. I need to have my boobs sitting up at this level at all times. They were like down to here. That's life-changing. Life-changing, but it gives me back fat. Gotta pick or choose your battles. That's what I learned in my life. Yeah. So why do you care to go to this? Because I was invited and I think it would be fun. When are you gonna act your own age? It's like rap crew, like Rick Ross and Diddy. Do you think this is like your crowd? I know a thing or two about rap music. Who is the boss?
One person who was always anti-Diddy and was always speaking about Diddy as a problematic person was 50 Cent. And it turns out that it's just been announced that he's created a docu-series on Netflix. I can't wait to see this. The other end of that, every person who has tried to speak out about this, who has tried to speak out about the industry, the type of people that are controlling the industry, the attacks that people face from the media if they try to speak out, is always the same. They're called crazy. And an example of one such individual who went through those sorts of attacks is the actor Orlando Brown. He was on Disney, and I remember everyone telling us that he was totally insane and deranged when he was saying a lot of things that at the time sounded crazy, particularly about Diddy. Take a listen.
The requirement is you gotta say no to Diddy. If it's new booty in the building, you know he gonna get it.
Don't take your girlfriend to a Diddy party.
You can take him, but he won't you.
Diddy, to me, is the fall guy. We are still seeing a major effort to protect the big names, just like with Jeffrey.
He tells us and shows us several elaborate parties thrown by music mogul Pete. We spoke with several others as well, describing 24 hours of partying at a time.
Sometimes they provide breakfast and a morning, and it's like you could chill. I'm just wild on how he's just able to keep all that energy. He just has a lot of energy, like, to be that age and to be throwing these parties so frequently.
It's all mood, often lighting, club love seen as themes. We heard about Art Basel and New Year's Eve events. Mm. More details coming to light after Diddy's arrest in New York earlier this
week. Who was with you this weekend? A bunch of my friends. Diddy, Quincy, Justin Bieber. So far, so good. Montana. Do you even know half the people you're naming? No.
She didn't go to bed.
I haven't been to bed yet.
You haven't? I want to be Clay when I grow up, Court.
I got on a plane at 5:30 a.m. to this party. I think half the people there were butt naked.
To get where you want to be at, you got to have principles, you got to have morals, you got to keep with that stuff. And in that music business, a lot of that stuff get thrown out the window. You understand? And that's what happened to him. He started doing the things to other people that was done to him. To keep it frank, he was doing the things to other people.
Man, you doing it, man. You deserve it, daddy. You putting in that work.
Diddy party stories, they're our favorite genre of anecdote. If
oh, really?
Have one. Yeah. Wow, okay, I've got a lot I can't tell. So, can't tell that one either. I mean, I'm like actually cycling through them.
Feel like, well, we still have some time to go. You know, I can blow it here.
Okay.
Dudes belong in jail based on what they do and how they do it. We know that to be true. And it's just this situation, man. When they get down to all the facts and all what happened, he may belong in jail, bro. And that's not my doing. That's not Cassie doing. That's his doing and his learned behavior from the people that mentored him. You gotta realize, man, he learned from Andre Harrell. He learned from Russell Simmons. He learned from Clyde Davis. You understand? When those people are telling you that they were in heavy into the drugs, they was heavy into beating women and doing things at that age, at that crazy stage, that's gonna make him think that he could get away with the same thing that they was getting away with back then. You understand? The things that he was saying, you know, the touchy-feely between two men.
Signing the bad boy.
Listen to the music. I've heard that song after party. but that was at the Holiday Inn, I think. All right, so, and how old are your kids now? How many kids you have?
I have six.
Six, and how old are they now?
Well, I mean,
you seem youthful. That's why they're
I'm
like,
youthful,
oh, yeah.
And I'm fertile.
Parties are the hottest ticket around.
They won't even give me a permit for the parties, man. They don't want me to throw the parties no more. But we ain't gonna stop. We gonna keep on having fun, bringing people together from all walks of life. You gonna hear about my parties. They're gonna be shutting them down. They're gonna probably be arresting me, doing all types of crazy things just because we want to have a good time. You know, whenever you bring up a different element into people's environment, things that broaden people's horizons, people get intimidated. There's a lot of people out there that feel intimidated by it. It ain't nothing but break it down racial barriers, break it down generation barriers. People from all walks of life. Ron Perlman talking to Jay-Z, Jay-Z talking to, you know what I'm saying? It just goes on.
All these stories has been around the industry for a long time. All these industry people know that Diddy been acting like this and doing this. And yo, it's a lot of stories that goes around in this industry about not just him, other people. Jimmy Iovine. Ain't nobody talking about Jimmy Iovine. He got sexual charges and everything on him. But he got those publicists that's keeping it out
off of CNN is keeping it off the major news reports. Nobody's talking about that. This is something that goes on, man, that they're gonna push up under the rug, and a few years later, Bad Boy 5, 6, 7, 8 will be out.
Hey, speaking of love.
This is love.
I saw a guy on the internet the other day who said he used to be your security guard, who said that when you were dating J-Lo, Will Smith and Jada tried to pick her up on a threesome and you were gonna beat up Will Smith. Is that true?
Well, this show has gotten crazier since the last time I ever beat kids. No,
it's all about love, though. That's
no,
not true.
You really heard that?
Well, yeah, I watched it on the internet. You're telling me I can't believe everything I read?
What? I don't know what you're talking about. Jimmy, I thought we was friends. What is this?
As the Evans mounts, it's clear that the implications of the Diddy cocktail scandal extend far beyond just one man. With each new revelation, the list of those potentially involved grows, pulling more celebrities into the fray. What started as a single investigation is now unmasking a network of secrets that could have significant consequences across the entertainment industry. Who else will be caught in this ever-widening net? Stay tuned as this story continues to unfold, promising more shocking developments. What's good, YouTube? It's Relink a few days ago, Cash.